guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a video on my hygiene routine, telling you guys literally what I use, why I use it. Hopefully this list can help you guys out. I'm gonna have this list linked down in the description box along with all the links to the exact products that I'm going to mention today. And if you've been looking to do a more cleaner hygiene routine and you're wanting to use more cleaner products but you just don't know what to do or where to start, this video will be perfect for you. Or if you just are into the more sustainable products and more natural way of doing things but you also just want to do like a refresh on the products that you currently have. But before we get into the video, you guys already know the deal. If you are interested in my natural hair brand at all and you want to follow me on Instagram, then go ahead and head over to Nourished by Shantae's Instagram. I'll have it here and also down in the description box for you guys to just easily click so that you can go over and give it a follow and support my natural hair care brand. Love you guys so much for those of you who have already done that. So these are going to be pretty niche product selections. I did that on purpose because I didn't want it to be overwhelming, especially for people who are new to my channel. So I'm gonna go ahead and start with the body wash that I use. So I have been using this Raw Sugar brand body wash for quite a while. Their products are normally in Target. That's where I normally see them. But I really like this product in particular because it is pretty clean. They do have some organic ingredients, which is something that I look for. So this is the Raw Coconut Plus Mango, and this is the one that I am using currently, but I use a lot of different raw sugar body washes. And I've tried the watermelon one. All their products smell really good. Like this one has a really good smell. Most of their products smell extremely good, so you don't have to worry about going wrong with that. So yeah, that's what I'm currently using for body wash. Both me and Naraya like this a lot, and also my boyfriend as well, so like this brand. So when it comes to down there, I am gonna say down there because YouTube has flagged my videos on hygiene when I use any type of different term, and it takes a while for them to take the flag off and they don't promote my video, people don't see it, da da da. But I'm not gonna take that chance. So in this video, we're going to talk like we're in second grade because YouTube prefers that. So down there, I definitely say that you should not be putting a lot of chemicals, a lot of different fragrances. And even though this is really good for my skin, I feel like that when it comes to your area down there is a lot more sensitive and you should take a lot more care on what you actually put down there. I have an entire video on that if you want to click here where I talk more in depth, but in my opinion, I feel like that you should really, really keep it simple. So one product that I recommend for you guys for that is the Honey Pot, and this is the sensitive formula, and this is basically a sensitive foaming wash for women. It basically helps with keeping everything nice and clean, but at the same time it doesn't distract the pH and the natural flow of, you know, that area. So it's a very good product. For this amazing formula, I would think that it would be way more expensive, but it's not. She does use very natural ingredients in this formula, and they are also certified organic, which is always a plus, and it is also cruelty-free. She does have a formula that has like a scent to it, but I always get the sensitive one just because I like to use that formula a lot more. So this is the one that I get all the time. And it's super easy to use. All you have to do is shake it, pump it into your hands, and it turns into foam. And they do suggest that you do not use any rags or anything when you are using this formula. Okay, so now that we got that out of the way, those are the only two body products as far as body wash that I'm gonna recommend to you guys today. I'm always changing my routines and trying out new things as long as they are organic and sustainable. So if I do another video like this, I'll try to include more body washes, but at the moment, this is what I'm currently loving. So now I'm gonna go on to the products that I use to moisturize my skin. And as far as my body, I'm not gonna do face care because I feel like that should be a whole nother video. But a lot of you guys ask me what I use on my skin. A lot of you guys question like, how do you always keep your skin so clear? Because I don't wear makeup at all, ever, FYI. In any of my videos, I never have on makeup. On the pictures on Instagram, I never have on makeup. I always have just my natural bare skin. So you guys ask me questions about that. So I'm gonna show you guys what I'm currently using at the moment with my skincare and tell you guys some general practices that I normally keep in place when it comes to my skin in general. The first thing I want to show you guys is the body butter that I'm currently using. So I do prefer body butters over lotions because I like really thick, heavy body butters that are going to really shine and help my skin like look amazing. We have the Pacifica body butter here. Now I will say I really like the fragrance of this product. I like the ingredients of the product. I like the way that Pacifica does everything with their product, but this in particular is not as thick as I normally would like a body butter to be. So it says intensely moisturizing. I think that that's, you know, pushing it a little bit. I think they kind of like did a little bit too much there. It's not intensely moisturizing. It is a moisturizing body butter, but not to the extent of what I was expecting. When they put intensely, I thought that it was gonna really give me like a nice moisturizing look. It doesn't last for as long as I would like it to as well. But I will try to give another like product from Pacifica line another chance because I do like Pacifica's products. I think just this one in particular, which is the Indian coconut nectar, just wasn't as up to standards as I thought it would be. I also have this body butter here, which was made for me by an old friend. This is definitely a homemade butter. It is made from mango butter, and I believe she has shea butter in here as well. I don't wear this one a lot because it is extremely thick, but if you guys want to make your own shea butters, you can make that for your body and make it like a whipped shea butter and just like play around with a couple recipes. In the winter time, these are really good to wear, but I'm one of those people who wear body butters during the summertime as well, so it just depends on what you want to do. Also, I don't wear this butter a lot because my boyfriend hates the smell and so does Naraya. They say that it smells really bad, but I don't see the problem. But if you are going to make your own body butter, just a FYI, make sure that you fragrance it to the way that you want to smell. Also, am currently loving this Kalia conditioning milk. So when I first got this, Kalia actually sent this to me, and I was like so confused on what it was. This is made with all organic ingredients, and this is basically a milk that you put on right out of the shower. So it's pretty much like a leave-in conditioner to condition your body, but you are supposed to put like an oil or a butter on top in order to keep the moisture in. So it's not like, you know, going to moisturize your skin and you don't have to do anything else. You are going to need something else. So I'll show you guys what it looks like. So this is what it looks like. It's really runny. As you see, it's running down my hand, my arm right now, if that's even showing up. So it's almost like basically a milk. It's very watery. So whenever you get finished with applying like a body milk or conditioner that's actually a milk, you're going to go ahead and put like a body butter or something on it to seal in the moisture. And that's one thing that I've didn't know at first, but now that I know it, it does work really good and it does hydrate the body. So it's not a moisturizing product, it's a hydrating product. Next product that I'm gonna show you as far as moisturizing my skin is the Nourish by Shantae Glow Rose Botanica Full Body and Face Oil, which is amazing. So of course, I love this product because it's a glow oil. As I told you guys, I love to have like glowy skin and just to look like I have like a really good natural glow going on. And this glow oil is one of my favorites. Besides it being my product that I was able to formulate, I love it because it has hydration included in the formula, which is not something that you see a lot with glow oils or with oils in particular, because when you put on an oil, it's not supposed to actually just moisturize your skin alone. It can be where you'll put on an oil and then the next like hour or the next 30 minutes or even the next 2 seconds, your skin will go right back to being dry. So that is because oils are not hydrating or moisturizing to the skin unless you add in hydration. So this glow oil has hydration added because of the infusion process. So I absolutely love the fact that I can put this on and be hydrated as well. So I use this a lot on my body and on my face as well. So of course it's a body and face oil, and it also has extremely good nutrients in the formula. It also has organic ingredients in the formula, which is amazing for your skin and honestly just helps with keeping your skin nice and healthy, just like with your hair. You just want to make sure that you're always putting on products that are carefully made and the formulas are like bomb, so that your skin and your body can actually thrive from those. So absolutely love this oil, one of my favorites. Definitely recommend this one. Last product that I'm going to talk to you guys about for this section of the video is the Nourish by Shantay Silk Hydrate Drop. So this is actually a toner, but it's a 3-in-1 toner. So there are times where I just use it for a toner, but there's also times when my skin, this is only when my skin feels extremely dry, I will put this on, and it pretty much works just like the conditioning milk. But with this one, it's more for soothing dry skin. So if you have like a dry patch or a part of your skin is super dry, you can apply the hydrate drops to it. Just make sure, as I told you guys with the conditioning milk, the hydrate drops is a hydrator, so it's going to hydrate your skin. So you're also going to need like a butter oil to actually seal in the hydration, so just keep that in mind if you ever use it that way. But I absolutely love this formula because of course it has organic ingredients, but it also has real calendula flower in it. Calendula flower is like a super jam-packed ingredient to have, so I absolutely love it. Also, there is poppy seed in here as well, which is super amazing for the skin. Okay, so the next thing I wanted to go to is definitely probiotics. Of course, you guys know that I graduated already, but I still have seminars and things like that that I go to be refreshed on certain ingredients and just refreshed on certain processes and just to gain more information and knowledge, which I absolutely love about that school. They send you stuff after you graduate as alumni as well. So just recently they were talking about gut health, how it directly correlates with the way that your skin looks and the way that you feel in general. So I just wanted to point out the fact that probiotics are super important for your gut. And if you have not found a good probiotic, I highly recommend that you do that because it helps so much. And your gut health just regulates pretty much all the things that are going on with your body. So even with hair fallout, that can definitely occur from having a bad gut health and bad gut environment. So it's pretty intense and I'm gonna make a video on it. Actually, thumbs up this video if you are interested in that topic. So I have the Mary Ruth probiotics here, and these are my favorite probiotics to use. These are the ones that I found that actually have worked for me. Some probiotics, I use them and I don't really see a result or I don't really feel anything, whereas these I can tell by using them that they are working really well for me. So this is the Mary Ruth probiotic Beauty Plus 63 Million. I've been using her products for a while now and I don't really change up my probiotic choice. I probably have a whole spill about probiotics down in the description box because it's very important. It helped me a lot to keep everything balanced. Highly recommend that you guys take your probiotics and prebiotics. So now I'm going to go ahead and go to fun part of the video, which is like the period talk. So I'm going to show you guys the type of pads that I use. So the first pad company that I'm going to recommend is the Honey Pot Company. So they specialize in herbal products, which you guys know that I absolutely love herbal products. So the Honey Pot Company has these pads where they have an herbal formula on, like, inside the pad. When it comes to pads, if you are unfamiliar, they put so many different chemicals and junk on the pads, and honestly, it's just mind-blowing that they're even allowed to do this. So mainstream pads that are not organic or that do not have a sustainable approach to the way that they're creating their products, they are using any and whatever they want on your products, and they really don't have to tell you because legally it's just not something that is regulated, and they feel like that it's a need for people to have pads, so they don't feel that it's, you know, they don't feel that they had to go into the whole spill of what's in their products. Whereas on the Honey Pot, they do tell you what ingredients they're using in their pads. These in particular help with cramps. So if you're having a really bad period or you're having a hard time with your period, using these are just they're gonna help you. I'm just gonna say it's gonna help your stomach feel a lot better. It's a very soothing formula that they're using. First, when you first get it, you're not going to be used to it and you're probably gonna be like, what the heck? But after a while, you're gonna notice that it is gonna help with soothing everything down there and it's just not gonna be such a pain. So I absolutely commend this company for their uniqueness and the fact that they came out with an original product and marketed in an original way. And then when you actually get home and try the product, you do see that it stands out a lot from other brands. So highly recommend Honey Pot if you haven't if you can't tell already. I love this company. So before I move on to the next pads that are non-reusable, I'm going to give you guys a little spill on reusable pads. So I know that sounds really weird, but hear me out. Don't click out the video yet. So I'll send me over their reusable pads. I have used reusable pads before. I do not use them anymore because I felt like the moisture of the reusable pads was just too much for me. But this is what they look like. This hasn't been used, of course. This is brand new and it was sent to me from Owl. I'll have their company link down below. And this to me, so when I started using reusable pads, it was very long ago, back in 2016. And the technology just wasn't up to par. A lot of people weren't, you know, doing it. The reusable pads that I got was probably not up to par as far as, you know, having all the ins and outs of what to do. So I actually stopped using them because I found that they were just collecting way too much moisture. And I feel like that having too much moisture down there is not ideal. I am going to give it another try with the Owl pads and I'm going to tell you guys my review of them. They also sent me over their period panties, which is my favorite. So these period panties, I know you guys have like a drawer of period panties that you have that you use because every girl normally has that. Well, they have them here. They look so big on camera and they look big in person as well, but they're super thick and you basically have like a really thick insert. Of course, I haven't used it. And they also give you this as well. So you can use these period panties as just wearing the period panties and allowing yourself to flow in them, or you can use them the way I do and I just take a non-reusable pad and I put it into the period panties and it just feels a lot more protected and I just know that nothing's gonna get through because I have a insert. The panties are super thick. I literally know that nothing's gonna get through these panties. So I absolutely love these period panties. They're very helpful. If you have not tried out period panties that are literally made for periods, then I highly recommend you try it out. So this last brand that I'm gonna recommend is definitely for those of you who don't have access to some of the brands that I mentioned when it comes to periods. So this is the L brand. Now these are more cost effective and they are at Target. So these are, they're just called the L brand. And they're not as high quality as the other brands that I just mentioned, but it is really good to have an accessible, non-toxic pad in Target that is in a huge package and cost effective. So on the subject of down there, I want to also mention the one and only apple cider vinegar. So I have this here, which is the apple cider vinegar that I got from Whole Foods, but I normally use the Bragg's apple cider vinegar, although they didn't have it in stock when I was there or something like that. I'm not for sure, but I got this brand because it does have With Mother. So as long as it has With Mother, then I'm okay to get it. So what I use this for is I sometimes put this in my bath water. It does naturally help with the pH. So I do that whenever I feel needed, whenever I intuitively feel that I need to do that. Also, I will add in Himalayan pink salt to make it like a salt bath. So Himalayan pink salt is so amazing. It's a very high quality salt. So this is the Evolution Salt Company brand. And these are the coarse grind rocks. I like to get the coarse rock because I can make salt baths with them, own little DIY salt bath. So this is what I'm currently using. And it's a huge bag, as you can see. And I did get this from Marshalls, but I'm not sure I think they have a website as well, but I'll leave everything down in the description box. Himalayan salt is really good at drawing out any type of toxins that you have within your body. So to shave, I'm going to definitely recommend the Flamingo brand. So I absolutely love this brand because their shavers are really, really high quality. Let me know in the comment below, do you shave or do you wax? Let me know. Good Chemistry is a company that uses all natural fragrances, and I just love their perfumes and body sprays. The only thing that they need to improve, they need to improve the fact that their fragrances don't last on you all day long as far as smelling to everyone else. So I personally smell it on me, but I don't feel that everyone else smells it. So if you guys have any suggestions of sustainable natural perfumes that you can recommend, then let me know down in the comment section. Okay, so now I'm gonna show you guys the type of toothpaste that I'm currently using. So my toothpaste is something that changes very often. I normally like to stick to toothpastes that are sustainably sourced, natural, have natural ingredients, pretty much the ground rule for pretty much everything that I showed you guys in this video. What I'm trying out currently is this toothpaste called Dave's, and I got this toothpaste. It came in this box here, and I got this because it said that it was a premium toothpaste. I wanted to see what the difference was. The packaging is very premium. They even give you this little device here to, like, when your toothpaste runs out, you can put it on there and squeeze it. Works really good. Told you guys last time in my video that I use coconut oil on my nails, and I use my growth oil on my nails sometimes as well. But I wanted to show you guys these cotton balls that I use. So these are organic cotton balls. So whenever I get cotton balls, I do get the organic cotton balls because they put a lot of mess on cotton balls, which at first I knew nothing about. So they put chlorine and things like that on the cotton balls that are just completely unnecessary. But if you get organic cotton, then they're not going to put all that on there. So that's what I stick to when I'm using cotton balls. So on my skin, on my face, on my nails, I always use organic cotton balls. So the last thing I wanted to show you guys is the deodorant I use. And I saved this for last because deodorant is actually one of the things that I just can never get down pat. Anybody who uses natural deodorants, maybe you know what I mean. If you use natural deodorants and you don't know what I mean and you found a really good deodorant, then please let me know down below. But this deodorant here is the Everyman Jack, which is a man's deodorant, and it's okay. I also have the Dove 0% aluminum here. So definitely if you are wanting to try new deodorants, then just play around with natural deodorants. It's kind of hard to find good deodorant. All right guys, so I hope that this video helped you out. If it did, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel, and I hope that all these options were helpful for you, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.